With strategic modeling, you can quickly model and evaluate financial scenarios. To work with strategic modeling's financial forecasting and modeling features, you create strategic models. If you already have models and templates within on-premise strategic finance, you can migrate them to strategic modeling. To migrate strategic finance databases and consolidations, you must migrate individual entities and templates. Complete the following steps. Take on-premise strategic finance entities and templates offline. Entities are stored as ALC files, and templates are stored as ALT files. Create a planning application in the cloud and enable strategic modeling. In order to convert the ALC and ALT files from on-premise to cloud, open each file in SmartView and save it. In SmartView, upload offline models to strategic modeling in the cloud. Optionally, import strategic finance templates into strategic modeling and build the consolidation hierarchy. If your on-premise Hyperion strategic finance version is not 11.1.2.4, upgrade it prior to migrating to the cloud. For migrating from on-premise strategic finance to strategic modeling in the cloud, I already completed the first two steps. From strategic finance, I took entities offline and saved them to a local directory. I took some templates from strategic finance too, and I created a planning application and enabled strategic modeling. To complete step 3, I'll use SmartView to connect to my environment where strategic modeling is enabled. I am going to open the strategic finance entity that I have saved locally. To convert the entity from on-premise to cloud, I'll open the entity file in strategic modeling and then save it. I am also going to open the strategic finance template that I saved locally. This converts the template from on-premise to cloud, and I'll save the template. You can repeat this process for each template you want to convert. Next, I'll complete step 4. To migrate the model to the cloud, you create a new strategic model and upload your local model to the cloud. I'll create an entity based on an existing model, the local file that I have from strategic finance. I'll keep the source model data. I'll place the model at the root to build a model hierarchy. When you migrate a model, all model artifacts such as POVs and reports are migrated to the new model in strategic modeling. To complete step 5, I'll use SmartView to import strategic finance templates into strategic modeling. This step is required only if you want to preserve the templates that you used to create the migrated models. In Source Template, select the template file to import. In Template Name, enter a unique name for the template in strategic modeling. You can repeat this process for each template you want to migrate. To complete the migration process, build a consolidation hierarchy. I'll enter a name for the consolidation. I'll build the new consolidation structure. Select a model for the consolidation. Consolidation hierarchies in strategic modeling represent the structure of your organization. I'll define the business case for this model. I'll continue to add to the consolidation structure and indicate the contributing scenario. I'll finish building my consolidation structure by adding corporate center with a contributing scenario of expected. I'll open the model I migrated to strategic modeling. I can perform actions from the strategic modeling ribbon. I'll select an account and take a look at subaccounts. I can manage subaccounts just like I did in strategic finance. Similar to managing forecast methods in strategic finance, I can manage them in strategic modeling. I'll take a look at funding options. Just like in strategic finance, I can set how to apply cash surplus or fund cash deficit. I'll close the model and check it in. I'll look at my model in the cloud, select strategic modeling, and then model view. I'll check out the model. The model is ready to work with in the cloud. You'll need to set up model access permissions in the cloud. For more information on setting up security for models, see the Setting Up Model Access Permissions topic in the Administering Planning Modules Guide. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.